Hello, my name is Luis Ganides. I'm a personal trainer and group fitness instructor in New York City. And today I'm gonna talk about how to achieve fitness, wellness, and strengthening your immune system. Meanwhile, everybody's practicing social distancing. One more challenge in our lives, huh? Not easy at all. So let's start by parts. Looking good, staying fit, what do you have to do to achieve it? Or feeling good, what do you have to achieve it? Or strengthen your immune system so you can fight any disease that comes around from inside out. What do you have to do to achieve it? Ends up that the three of them are highly connected. Highly connected. When you pursued one, it's almost the same things you have to pursue the others. So looking good, feeling good, and staying healthy are highly connected. And I'm gonna split that by portions, by parts. First, I'm gonna talk about movement. Second, I'm gonna talk about eating habits. Third, I'm gonna talk about vitamin D, right? And fourth, I'm gonna talk about stress mode against a calmer state mode, right? So let's start with movement. What can you do from inside of the house to feel good, to pump your lymphatic system and help expel the toxins out of your body? How to get some movement in and remind your body we are animals and not plants? So ends up that long as you stay not moving, like sitting down long hours, that makes your body understand you're in a morbid state, like you're training your body to not burn calories, just to stay there, hanging in there, right? So less you stay on that state, better it is. And there are a lot of studies that prove that if you remember to move through the day, every hour, for example, that counts more than not moving at all and then doing 1 hour exercise at the gym. So what about that? You put a timer on your cell phone, something not very alarming, right? And nobody needs extra stress right now, to remind you that it's time to move. It's time maybe to go and do 10 jumping jacks, 10 squats, and 10 sit-ups, right? And there's options of low impact for all of that. You do that 3 rounds, or you do 1 round, and then, you know, you get back into working or doing something else. Or why not try to get in a nice game with your kids, like hide and seek, now that everybody's home. Or maybe look for something to clean, something you need to organize, something to get the body moving again, especially if you have a backyard, if you have a private area with sunlight, you know, your own space. Why not try to go there and do something? So you don't have to get crazy and go for 100% and give it all. I think that this kind of mindset tends to push you away from exercising. So you can do something that between 0 to 10, being the 10, the most challenging, something around 6 that you feel the cardio kicking in, you feel your body moving. And you don't have to get crazy because you're going to get back to something in 1 hour later or maybe 2 hours later, right? You don't have to go and give it all the time. You can do things that you just feel challenged for a little bit to get the heart rate to pump again, get your blood moving, all your systems from the body to move in harmony. We need to move. We are animals. We are not plants. So this is one thing that you should definitely focus on, how to stay moving through the day. Second thing, stretching counts. Stretching using the foam roller. There's so many different things, you just need to open up your mind. Second thing, if you decide to do online classes, this would be great if you can put on your schedule and adjust your schedule. Can be 30 minutes or can be 45 minutes or an hour, and maybe 3 times in a day, or twice, or just once, whatever you can do on that day, put on your schedule, put an appointment for that when you're gonna take care of yourself and do a little exercise. And then you can go for different options online. There's so many things out there. I would just focus a little bit more into low impact and feel good things right? Low impact, cardio, to not go from 0 to 100. If you haven't been exercising, you can't just get crazy and start doing high intensity things because your joints probably are not ready for that load. You start increasing little by little. So you can look into yoga, Pilates, low impact. There is so many different things you can research and find something that fits you, right? Okay, so these are two different ways that you can look into bringing movement to the day, through the day. How to make you feel good, how to make you look good, how make you get your immune system stronger, right? You gotta get ready. So I like to make a comparison with our ancestors. Our ancestors, they had, when they would wake up, they had to go somewhere to find food, or they had to run after something so they could eat, right? Hunting, or they had to run away to not become food. So I like to compare this with nowadays. For us, nowadays it's so easy to just wake up and open the refrigerator door and grab something to eat without any effort, without burning more than 2 calories. So keep that in mind, right? Let's deserve that meal. Let's put your body to work, your body and your mind to work, and that meal is gonna feel better. Especially because if you did so much effort, why are you just gonna go there and eat anything, right? So much effort for nothing. And I do like to compare the ancestors towards the next topic, that is eating habits. Eating habits. So how many meals should you have a day? Or what is about the intermittent fasting? Like, is that okay? What's going on with all those subjects? Everybody talks so much. Should I eat every 3 hours? What should I eat? So I like to compare with the ancestors as well. They didn't have food available for them all the time. They had to deserve the food, and they would have a day or 2 days they wouldn't eat anything, or maybe it would take 10, 12 hours until they could find something to eat. And that goes towards the intermittent fasting. And it's kind of easy to understand. If you wanna burn fat in your body, because what is fat? Fat is an energy source for you to go after in case you need, right? So how are you gonna burn fat if you're eating all the time, if you're feeding your body all the time? And what is gonna happen if you're feeding your body all the time and you're not burning those calories? You see how it's like, you know, it's easy to understand. So a good way to induce your body to burn fat is intermittent fasting that you can do. For example, your last meal is 3 hours before going to bed. Let's say you're gonna go to bed at 10 p.m. Your last meal is at 7. And then your first meal, you're gonna delay a little bit. You know, if you wake up at 7 a.m., you're gonna try to eat after 10 a.m. Or if you're not hungry, you don't have to eat. You can go further towards 12 p.m., 1 p.m. And if you really wanna get deep into this, because when you achieve your body, inducing your body to burn fat, you're getting this high level of wellness and health. This is how our bodies are programmed to work. So you don't have to just trust on what I'm saying. You can go after some deep information about this. Anyway, so postponing the first meal and giving a big space between meals is going to induce your body to burn fat. And don't misunderstand the signals. Many, many times we are just thirsty and then, or super anxious, and then you wanna eat, right? So try to drink water, plenty of water through the day, that's very important, and try to postpone the first meal. Now, I'm gonna get deep into this. What are you gonna eat when you're hungry? Then it's like, okay, this is it. I held enough, I think I'm good. Now I can't hold it back. Because there is a difference between fasting and being hungry and starving, right? Fasting and starving. Fasting, it's an option. When you enter starvation, it's because you don't have an option. In this case, we have an option. We are just postponing it. And then whenever you're gonna eat, you need to think of what can you eat that is not gonna make you feel like you don't wanna stop eating. I don't know if you have that problem. I have that problem. If I eat one cookie, I don't stop until I eat the whole bag or to me it's really hard to have one slice of pizza or one little bowl of popcorn. No, there are things that your body just likes it. Your body and your mind is just like, yes, I want more and more and more. And it's hard to stop. After you get on that loop, it just keeps going and going and going. So how can you have better choices that are gonna give you nutrients and it's gonna make you feel full and not anxious? There is a high connection between easy sources of carbs. And I would say, for example, things that don't have many nutrients and much fiber, right? And there is a big difference between that and other options that have more nutrients and fibers. And it's very easy to associate that. For example, a cup of soda, right? You have to be very careful with liquid because it just goes through your digestive system like crazy, especially because it has no fibers and has no nutrients. Your body tends to store around the belly. So I have to be very careful with that. So a cup of soda or a cup of green juice. Huh? Green juice with almost no fruits. You can't put too much fruit in a green juice, right? What do you think you will sit better on your body? Makes you feel less anxious. I don't know, Coca-Cola just gives me like a spike of energy that is crazy. And some food sources, they give that, they give you the spike. But afterwards, that spike goes down. And then what do you go after? For more spike, You need that energy, quick energy source. And it's easy to understand when you compare like fire. If you put a place, if you threw a piece of paper in there, it's just gonna burn fast, right? It's gonna get that spike. Different when you threw a piece of wood that is gonna be slowly burned through the day. So for example, you would like to stay to avoid carbs or in like anything that you can think of that doesn't have much fiber and nutrients, like pizza, bread, pasta, cookies, chocolate, right? Instead of that, you wanna go for things that are have better nutrients and more fibers. And you can think about whole foods. You can think about healthy fats, for example, avocado, olives, or fish, eggs, steak. I'm already going through proteins and other things. If you feel like you wanna eat something sweet, you eat a fruit, right? You try to go for things that are gonna give you nutrients and is gonna help with your immune system and is gonna keep your anxiety, stress levels lower. That is not gonna spike your hunger hormones. It's gonna keep it a little bit calmer, right? You wanna go for those things instead of things that are just gonna get you more anxious, more filled with energy at once, you know, and then you're just gonna feel like you wanna keep eating it, eating and eating. So that's why I really like what I do. When you explain the idea, it's easier than for me to tell you, eat once a day, twice a day, or three times a day, this or do that. Like, you know, so try to give a big space between meals. Whenever you're gonna eat, 0 to 5, being 5 the fullest, if you stop at 3, eating slowly, not anxious, with the TV off if possible, right? To not get you crazy with things. And you wanna go for options that have high level of nutrients and fibers. Now, if you already stocked your house and you have a lot of junk there that is easy to go after, you're gonna have to deal with it. You're gonna have to space it out, come up with some good ideas. I don't know. I feel like it's just an addiction. I don't buy those things because they are in my house. I just keep thinking about it when I'm gonna eat that cookie or that chocolate or that cup of soda. So try to avoid those things. Try to avoid to have those things at home because it's hard. It's so freaking hard. So further away from you, the less hard it is. All right, third thing you can do, exposure to sunlight if you have no skin problems. You know, that's your best source for vitamin D. You can do like 20 minutes a day, less than that maybe, or split it through the day. If possible, with a nice, behind a nice window, it is open, right? No glass in between. A nice time frame between 8 a.m., 9 a.m., 10 a.m., or at the end of the day. Anything you can do to feel that nice sunlight with some nice fresh air, this is gonna make you feel like a million bucks instead of just staying in the house in a dark spot with the TV on And this is my last topic, stress mode, right, against a calmer state mind, right? I'm sorry, I know I'm messing up my English sometimes because I'm originally Brazilian. So, what are the things that get you very stressed out? Like, I don't have a TV at home because it really gets me anxious and I feel I just want to look at the TV and eat, so I really avoid the TV. And nowadays, it's easy to keep that stress load very high because we have the TV, then you have the phone with social media bringing more news, or even though a message from a friend that wants the best for you, but is still giving you that bad news, right? So you don't have to stay on that bad news loop through the day, the whole day. Try to turn it off the TV a little bit and stay away from whatever gives you stress. And I don't know, put some nice music, dance a little bit, that counts as movement through the day, or something relaxing. Get a nice bath with Epsom salt, you know, things that are gonna help you feel good, because it's normal we get stressed out. It's okay. The problem is when you're stressed out all the time, we need some calmer moments. And we can get back into our ancestors, right? There were moments of high adrenaline when they had to run after food or not to become food. I don't know. And then there were moments they were just laying down on the grass looking to the sky. So do you have those moments when you can just shut down your mind of the stressful, worrying thoughts and have some quality of time when you relax and you enjoy where you are and you take some nice breaths? Right? So this is what I would like you to think, because less stress, less cortisol levels, and healthier you are. It's highly connected, the three of them, and better you feel. And I'm gonna finish with this now. I'm sorry, there is just one more. Socializing, it's so important to feel good, to feel well, to feel loved. We need to have that feeling, the community sense that we belong somewhere, that we have friends and family that care about us and we care about them. So try to practice that through FaceTime, through messages, through calls. Try to give attention to people that you love, right? You're gonna receive that love back. Trying to keep the alarm state, those bad news all around, right, all the time. People are getting enough of it through TV. So, you know, just how are you? How you feel? I miss you. Oh, remember this, remember that story. Things that are gonna make people feel better. That's what we need right now. Everybody to feel better, because everybody's going through a hard time. So we can try to live better, even though it's such a weird moment. We will figure it out. We just need to stay optimistic and strong. So I do hope you liked what I said. Please feel free to connect. And hopefully I'll see you soon.